Hey, it's Camo with the Nashville Access Show presented by Solis North Gulch Apartments, where taste matters. Speaking of taste, you can only have the best taste in the world if you're watching this show today, because we have one of my favorite guests ever to have on the show, and his name is John Barry. So many things I could talk about to introduce him, but we'll just get him in here and do the talking himself. How you doing, John?
I'm doing terrific. How are you?
Good to see you.
Nice to see you.
Have a seat. First of all, glad to have you back in action.
Thank you.
After your recent bout with, throat cancer?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
How many times is this now? You've had to go through the wars with that?
Well, it's the first time I've had cancer.
Okay.
But I've, you know, I've had an array of medical issues.
Yeah.
I am fully defective. So, they didn't hold out on any... defective parts on me.
Yeah, but you're coming back and you're looking really good, so
thanks.
You're feeling better?
Yeah, still not eating, so.
That always seems, people I know that have had kind of similar things, that always seems to be like the last thing to come back.
Yeah.
And they do a lot of smoothies.
Well, milkshakes is really all I can tolerate.
Is it the taste?
No, it's the swallowing, the chewing and swallowing. Taste is back. Taste for a while there was real metallic.
Yeah, you're saying that the only thing you could tolerate was the orange
cream sodas, orange cream milkshakes from Arby's, which they just discontinued for the season. They'll be back next spring. But my taste is getting back pretty good. But the saliva glands don't work. So there's no enzymes to help break the food down. So the food just sort of wallows around and gets really disgusting. but milkshakes work really good. So chocolate, I can't do chocolate. I can't eat chocolate.
Wow.
It tastes burnt, has a burnt flavor. So I haven't got that back.
I'd even give that. I can't taste anything, and it's just because of allergies.
Oh, wow.
Taste or smell. And sometimes that's a good thing.
Yeah. I can smell, I can walk down the street and there'll be one of these restaurants out here with a barbecue thing going. I'm like, oh man, that'd be awfully good. But I know what it'll end up doing. But
I can walk through the barbecue cloud and not even, it could be a house fire for all I know.
Yeah.
But I think on behalf of everybody, welcome back to the season.
Oh, thanks.
And can't wait to hear more from you.
We're looking forward to getting back out on the road. We're heading out we've got dates all coming up this fall and into the winter, so we're excited.
Which is a perfect lead-in to a Christmas tour.
Yeah, 23rd year.
Wow.
Yeah.
Those are a big deal for you.
Yeah, for me, it is. It's not only is it just provide for us financially for our family and our life, but all that aside, just to be able to go out and do this tour every year and to share this music, it's just awesome.
Wow.
It really is.
Yeah, and people, your fans look forward to it, and they keep coming back year after year.
Yeah, and we're trying to. Matter of fact, we just came up with set list yesterday. The first draft of the set list yesterday, and we've got a few songs that we've never recorded or ever performed before, and which is I thought I'd done them all. So, but there is a couple of songs that we're gonna. There's a lot of versions of these particular songs, but I haven't heard a version that really jazzes me up, so I'm going to have to come up with something of my own, so something that works for me. So.
Is that, I was going to say, your Christmas tour is like your Christmas time, but is that something that you kind of get in your head and plan for almost from the end of Christmas?
Starting January 2nd.
Wow.
Yeah. Matter of fact, well, actually, I think we're already on to next year. We're already locking in dates for next year. So
I guess the booking you have to do quite a bit.
We get that on that pretty far in advance, and just making some plans for the next few years what we're going to do. And
I'm really happy for you because that tour just seems to. When I see you touring and talking about that tour, it just seems to put a balance in your step.
It really is. It's a lot of fun, and we fortunately get to play a few new places every year. Like this year, we'll be in Shipshewana, Indiana for the first time.
Which is just a hassle even saying it.
Yeah. I'm looking forward to that. It's a great venue there, but I've never played there before, but I have friends who have played there a lot. They said, man, how come you haven't been there? So we're excited to see that on the books this year. And then there's places that we go to almost every single year, like Macon, Georgia. We've been every year. And Watkinsville, Georgia, where I lived a good part of my life. Yeah. We go home to Watkinsville and play. Different places, you know, so it's a lot of fun.
Wow. Now, as well as the Christmas thing, you've got a new single. Well, it's a recent single that's doing very well. Tell us about that.
Well, Richest Man is a song I wrote with Will Robinson and Liz Hingber. And it's a song I wrote about my dad, Jim. My dad was a pretty cool guy, hardworking construction worker, and you know, provided for our family. By no means was a wealthy man at all financially. And I really didn't have any intention of writing a song about my father, because I had recorded a song years ago called 40 Again that was written by Troy Seals, Sean Greenbaum. And I would tell a long involved story about my father, and we'd play this song, and it just felt like it was a song I wrote, you know, and people assumed I did. But I had that great song, 40 Again, that these fellas wrote, and I just never felt the need to, you know, pen one myself. Mm-hmm. But Will and Liz and I were just sitting around talking, and like great songwriters they are, they were asking a lot of questions about my life so we could write something that would be appropriate for me to sing. And started talking about family and different things, and next thing we know, the song just sort of spills out on the table. Will referenced, he said, we didn't write this, and we were gifted it. So, I kind of like that.
Is that important to you when it comes to song selection? Songs that fit your life and who you are?
Oh, yeah. And
you're not going to go out and kind of cheat in song.
Yeah, I mean, I've always been really particular that I do songs that when I sing them, you'll believe me.
Yeah.
That it probably hasn't, helped my career any. But me as an artist, I mean, that's important to me.
Well, I think people buy into your credibility. And so if credibility is damaging your career, which would you rather have, credibility or...
Yeah. Well, I'd like to have a credibly successful career.
I remember Leroy Parnell told me that he never was a big success. He always kind of, his career was always just kind of right along in the middle, and he would see people going up and then coming down and then going up and coming down, but he just stayed there and stayed constant all the way.
Yeah.
Is that something you kind of think you've done with your career?
Well, mine's had some peaks and valleys, but I think in recent years it's just been sort of, you know, I don't want to say flatlined.
No, not at all.
But it's just been consistent.
Yeah, I don't mean.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't understand.
You want to do Richest Man for us?
Sure.
And then we'll talk some more.
Yeah. I knew a man, thought he had it all.
It's a big house with a 10-foot wall. And though his friends were mostly bought, he still thought he had it all. But the richest man I ever knew lived behind a picket fence. He met my mom at 22, they could barely pay the rent. After dinner at the diner, he took more than he could afford. And on the way back home, I'd sit next to the richest man I ever knew. His final breath last fall. Well, the nurse didn't quite know who to call for the man who thought he had it all. But the richest man I ever knew filled the old stone church, and the stories that we listened to told what his life was worth. He went to meet his maker in his only Sunday suit on the day that I said goodbye to the richest man I ever knew. Someday again I'll sit next to the richest man I ever knew.
Watching the Nashville Access Show with Camo, presented by Solis North Gulch Apartments. My guest today, the incredible talent that is John Barry. You not only musically walk the walk, but in your life as well, you've done some pretty amazing things for other people. When the hurricane hit Texas, you were there and helping people out. Does that all go to creating the music?
No, I don't know. It's just, yeah, you see stuff like that, like the hurricane hit the coast, and he's got to do something, you know? I think a lot of people that watch on the news and they see stuff like that happening, they go, I wish I could do something, but I got to be at work at 7, you know?
Yeah.
And my life affords me, I've got time here and there where I've, you know, not on the road, or we're not recording or whatever, or I can change some things, and we have the capability to get on the bus and driving out to Texas to go help.
Yeah. So, well, you were supposed to be going on holiday.
Well,
And that happened, and you just said,
it'd be pretty tough to sit on the beach and knowing that just, you know, go down to the Gulf Coast and sit on the beach and have cocktails.
Yeah.
While if you just go down the beach line a couple of hundred miles, there's people down there suffering. That just didn't sit with me, so.
And then you got into the studio, cut a killer song with a bunch of your friends.
Yeah, I got together with Chuck. Matter of fact, I had a scheduled writing appointment with Chuck on this particular Monday, Tuesday of that week, whatever it was. And it was that weekend before the hurricane hit. And Robin called me up and she sent me a text. She said, "Are y'all watching the news? The after effects of this hurricane in Texas." And I said, "Well, we got the TVs on, with the volume down. We see what's going on." But she said, "We got to do something. What can we do?" And I said, "Hang on." And about 30 minutes later, I sent her the first verse and chorus of "All Come Together." And she sends me a text back. She said, "Don't rush home. Get that finished before you come home." And by the time I got home, she and our manager, Brian Smith, had been on the phone calling friends to see who could all get together to cut.
They were pretty powerful friends.
Yeah, some good artists showed up.
John Oates, Camo.
Yeah.
Wow, I can't even remember everybody that was on
there. There's a ton of people, man. Yeah. Just a ton of people. Heidi Newfield. Yeah. She came, not only sang, but did that wonderful harmonica of hers. Oh, it makes me sick. I play harmonica on one song.
Yeah.
Heart of Gold, Neil Young.
Yeah. Which is probably the easiest thing to play on her.
Yeah. You know, and I nailed it. I mean, I got perfect.
Yeah.
And I can't figure out any other song in the world on harmonica. I said, Heidi, how much would lessons be?
It's a testament to who you are as a human being that those people all came together and then came together again to help raise some money for you when you got diagnosed with cancer.
That's overwhelmingly, I mean, the kindness of the Nashville community when that all happened. Because I was the last person to, I kept telling Brian, he said, well, we should do something. I said, I don't want to do anything.
Yeah.
I said, you know, if you're going to have cancer, if I'm going to have cancer, which I do, the best time of year for me to have it is after the Christmas tour when we financially are stable.
Yeah.
And he called me back. He said, man, I got all these friends calling, your friends, my friends calling, wanting to do something. So we decided to put this thing to the folks at City Winery. City Winery were kind to offer their venue. And then we decided that we would partner with the Music Health Alliance to give a bunch of money to them to help their work in providing health care and help finding health care for musicians.
I'm with you there. I mean, Music Health Alliance and Music Care is both incredible charities.
Oh, yeah.
I benefited from as well. So
yeah, they've been a big help to me. Music Health Alliance. They helped my wife Robin kind of oversees our healthcare stuff and all that and making sure. But they worked with her to find the right company and you know all that. It was just they at the right time, man. They really came on board a couple years ago, really. And then long before all this happened, you know, just to be sure we were all taken care of.
Nice. You want to do another song for us?
Sure. What should I do?
You got a favorite?
How about Your Love Amazes Me? Let's go back to that one. That was your massive hit. What year was that? 1994. 94. Man.
Around another medical condition.
Oh, maybe it's an omen. You'll have a big hit with the new song.
Yeah, there you go. Amazing Me was written by Chuck Jones and Amanda Hunt Taylor, and just a remarkable song. I mean, I don't think the singer mattered. I was the lucky guy who drew the card, and it's just one of those great songs. Andy, his name's going right out of my head. I'll think of it later tonight, and I'll call you.
And it will tell you.
Oh, what's his name? Tanya Tucker also had this song on hold for her album, and we were both on Capitol, and I said, well, I want the second hold if she doesn't use it for some reason. And sure enough, she ended up not including it on her album, but then a few years later included it on her greatest hits package, and it's a great version. She did a great job, of course. Tanya is awesome. And Andy Childs, that's it. Sorry, Andy, you just wouldn't come to me. But Andy Childs cut Your Love Makes Me Feel and did a great job as well. It was just the timing and maybe the circumstances with the single coming out. And matter of fact, the single had come out and was starting to make just a little bit of noise. And then I sang at CRS at the New Faces show, and did that song. And then a few weeks after that, is when I had to have the brain surgery, and nothing kick a song into number one like good medical situation.
P.T. Barnum said, any publicity is good publicity.
I've seen the sad wonders of the world. I've seen the beauty of diamonds and pearls, but they ain't nothing, baby. Your love amazes me. I've seen a sunset like make you cry, colors of a rainbow reach across the sky. The moon in all its phases, your love amazes me. Don't you ever doubt this love of mine. You're the only one for me. You give me hope, you give me reason, you give me something to believe in. Forever faithfully, your love amazes me. I prayed for miracles, never came. I got down on my knees out in the pouring rain, but only you could save me. Your love amazes me. Don't you ever doubt this love of mine. You're the only one for me. Give me hope, you give me reason, give me something to believe in. Forever faithfully, your love amazes me. Your love.
So cool having you perform that just feet away. It's amazing. We've got a couple of things to do here. Nana's cookie jar doesn't have cookies in it.
Nana's not an issue.
No.
Okay. Just want to be sure.
No, we used another jar for that. and we needed the space, so we got rid of the ashes. this is called Ask It Answered. So our viewers have sent in questions. And so you get the draw.
Oh, those wacky viewers.
Yes. So, let's pull out a question there. All right. This is from Norm in Scotland. What's your favorite movie soundtrack?
Man from Snowy River.
Ooh. Didn't have to think too much about that.
No, it's my favorite movie soundtrack.
That's a great movie.
We used several of the pieces in our wedding. We got married.
Wow.
Yeah, several of them.
That is a fun movie to watch too.
Yeah, it's long, it's involved. Yeah. You gotta really pay attention, and the cinematography is fantastic.
When they're running the horses
down. Going down that, and then it's like you're kidding. And I'm a horse guy. Yeah. I'm like, there's no way. But it's pretty incredible.
And Kirk Douglas playing twins.
Yeah, they're pretty funny, and. And to just add a little bit to the story, which even makes the soundtrack more important to me personally, is my my sister Susan had five children, and her oldest Rachel, their family, the Becker family, and this family from Australia through mission work got to know each other very well and became dear friends. Susan and Danny and this couple from Australia became dear friends. They met in France, if I'm not mistaken. And stayed in touch all these years, and raised their families on opposite sides of the world.
Yeah.
And but long, very long story short, Rachel, the oldest girl, ended up marrying their son.
Wow!
And she went to Australia to visit his family, and which they would do often. The kids would go back and forth to visit, and
she's there, and he, the young man, had called my brother-in-law to ask about Mary and ask if he could marry her, propose to her. And they went on a picnic, and they were at the front porch of the ruins of Jim's cabin.
Wow.
In the Snowy Mountain region, and that's what he asked her to marry him. So I instantly love the guy. So, but yeah, that's pretty incredible. It's an incredible movie. It's very moving. But the music is like, yeah. Wow.
Thanks, Nora, for the question. So there you have it.
Lots of long story for nothing.
John Barry's favorite movie soundtrack is The Man from Snowy River. So keep sending your questions. It's asked and answered. Just send us a private message on Facebook, and we'll get your questions into Nana's ugly cookie jar. Man, thanks for being here today.
You bet, man. Thank you.
I think this is about the third or fourth time we've had you, and it's a pleasure having you anytime. So
thank you.
If you got something to talk about, come back.
Awesome.
You're right. Well,
appreciate it. Thanks. Very kind of you.
Thanks for watching the Nashville Access Show this week. Watch for me, or listen for me, every week on Chris Country across the UK, Sundays at midday following the Bobby Bones Show, and on Tamworth FM 88.9 in Tamworth, Australia, every Thursday morning with Jody Crosby and John Wolfe. Thanks for watching the Nashville Access Show. We'll see you next time.